Only five of us here now. Obi and Pastor Mike, right? You are Pastor.
Please.
And my guy here. Okay, what's that your name again? Raphael, yeah, Raphael. And I myself, we are preparing for our mission here today. We have only 45 minutes to spend and then we'll be off again back to town.
He's playing.
Located here now. Mm-hmm. Okay. The part, this is where they laid the pipe. It started.
Okay.
DC has already done a great job. He has already laid the pipe all the way down there, and then the water has been connected inside the cells, which is the main project that he has done here. And there are some other works that he did outside. He need to down here, just like focus on him. And
I hope you are not taking my.
And his foot. He don't wear any shoe.
Okay.
So and his name is DCP Akilu Abdullah. Abdullah is the one that's in charge of this place, and okay. He has been doing a great work handling the yard very quiet and calm. God bless you, sir. God bless
you, sir. Thank you, sir.
God bless you. If you dey back for that place, compose for that side. You understand?
Is now connected the pipe has been connected back there, and then extra tank has also been gotten in, and then now the water channel is where the connection is. So he has done a great job, and this kind of job to be frank, this kind of job, we have given it to some DCPs and they never deliver. I have to be honest.
Yes.
We have, this one is, on Monday we gave the money and he delivered the job today. Yesterday even he done with the job. So I'm really proud of you, sir. And we appreciate you, DCP.
Thank you.
We appreciate you. And the water will flow. Now they can be able to get water inside here. I'm so happy. Congratulations, everybody.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you all, okay? God bless each and every one of you.
Thank you, sir.
We will help you more and more.
Okay,
Thank you everybody. Ah, my Gio, how now? God bless you. We're going to do picking and then we're going to get out from here because I'm rushing back to Lagos tonight. If I'm lucky, I can get my flight back to Lagos tonight. But if I don't miss out, it has to be tomorrow. Okay, sir, let our guy.
Hello. So he's now today the project president, even though he came here a day before yesterday. You know, when he told me his intention, I said that we have a problem at hand. That is the water connection of possibility. He was the pastor. He was the pastor. He was the pastor. The pastor is now on this grid. And he went out, you know, a dated attention with you. To just give you some encouraging words, he's not here to preach, but he's here to advise, to encourage you so that you should know that there is life after imprisonment. It's one thing that when you are in the prison, you know, you are reaching the end of the road. So I'm proud and privileged to introduce to you our career, Mr. Christian Sassan. Thank you very much.
I appreciate each and every one of you. I have been here two times. That guy was also there. And I thank God that many of you have gone home. But the problem now is, it's not you going home that is the issue. The issue is when you come out from here, which way out? Where are you heading to? That is the question. I have been to 165 prisons in Nigeria. Over 5,000 has been released. 40-something death sentences have been pardoned in Nigeria since I came here. And in Lagos alone, more than 20-something death sentences. But do you know that among those 20-something death sentences, we have about three of them that went back to prison? Three death sentences. You know, imagine you are in prison for 13 years and you got amnesty, you are pardoned. And then after 6 months, 3 months, you went back to prison. That is madness. That's all I want us to focus today and stop it. Because there is only one chance you have to live. If you die, there's no other chance. I was a, let me share my testimony because there's no time. I was a brutal drug dealer. I was born and raised in Aba, in Abia State. I'm from Anambra. I'm from Nero originally. You know, and then... I know when I say I'm from Nnewu, they will laugh at me because my people love money so much. I mean, particularly where I come from, you know, in Umudi Nnewu, people always say that we love money so much. But you know what? Yes, love of money nearly destroyed me. I was one of those that loved money so much, and I nearly lose my whole life because of that. But you know, let me tell you something, please. We are not here to make jokes now. If you can only give me your ears, please, attention, please, sirs. Sirs, please grant me your ears, please. Just give me 30 minutes of your time. I promise your life will not remain the same. Just give me 30 minutes. 30 minutes, okay? And I will be out of here. And you do whatever you want to do. God bless you. My name is Evangelist Christian Chukwuka. I was born and raised in Aba. And I was from a very poor family. No money to send me to school. But because of that, I was sent for slavery to Cameroon. I was as a slave in Cameroon, nearly lost my life. I ran away from there. Second time to Maiduguri, I escaped from that death as well. When I got back to where I was born, my mother sold everything she had and gave me 10,000 naira, all that she could realize. I used that money, traveled to Lagos, rented a shop for 9,600 naira, had only 400 naira left. What can you do with 400 naira? But God lifted me with only 400 naira. But then, while I was in Lagos, 6 months, I made over 200,000 naira because the testimony was so bright. I was an honest and decent person. But you know that your honest and decent person doesn't guarantee that you will end up well. When you make a mistake at the long run, you might go wrong. Everything might go wrong. I was moving without understanding that I'm going to make it in life. I was so sure of myself. But then one day something happened. I saw some guys coming out from abroad, showing off, you know, spending money. Then greed coming to me. That's the work of Satan. When Satan comes into you and begins to show you that way, that fast way to make money, it is not the right way. Don't listen. Don't follow that way, because that way is why many of us are here today. Am I lying? It's because of money that many of us are here. Is it not true? Because of money, love of money. And you go and kill somebody. It's because of the money that you made you to go into that trouble. You don't need to have that love of money, because the Bible says that love of money is the root of all evil. He did not say that money is root of evil. He said love of money. When you love money, you are about to destroy your own destiny. And I was like that. I loved money so much. When I got to that extent, you know, my brother, I find myself traveling to African country, sold everything I have in Nigeria, then got to Gambia, rented a house in Gambia. While I was in Gambia, moving all African countries, raising money, suddenly, I saw all the money that I was making in Gambia were on nothing to compare what I was doing in Nigeria here. But the shame to go back to Nigeria was too much, because everybody have seen me like a big boy. You know, when pride comes into you, you don't want to step back where you come from. You want to remain on top, and you're not on top. That's how I was feeling. That I was a big boy, and my money was diminishing in Gambia. At last, I had only $3,000 left. That $3,000 was what I looked at it, I said, God, what am I going to do with my life? I can't stay here and continue, and my money will finish. I will live a shameful life in Gambia. Somebody told me, go to immigration, they will help you to get a passport. I went to immigration office in Gambia. I go there to go and lie. I ask them to give me Gambia passport. They said that you will pay $1,500. I said, okay, I will pay. I gave them $1,500. Then another thing again, because of love of money, I changed my identity, and that's where the problem started. Because I can't carry my name with the Gambia passport. They gave me another name, not Christian Okezie, they gave me Omar Bashir. I carried that passport with the name, I did not even know what it means. I carried that name, traveled to London. When I got to London, they arrested me, said that I don't look like a Gambian. They looked at me and said that you are an Igbo man. They did not even make a mistake. They did not say that you are a Nigerian. They look at my face and they say you are an Igbo man with a Gambia passport. Do you know what? I just within myself, I began to panic. Fear comes inside me because they know me more than I know myself. Are you hearing me, sir? They know me more than I know myself. And then, all the whole story, they pick up the phone, when call Gambia, the Gambia said to them, no, he's a Nigerian truly, but he's a Gambian national. So there's nothing you can do about it. They allow me to move on. Go to Sweden, try to enter Denmark, they deport me back. Try to enter Germany, they deport me back. In Sweden there, I say, let me go and seek asylum. Run into a refugee camp. Lie to the police that my mother is dead, my father dead. Listen to me, all these things are lies because I want to make money. I say, my father was dead, my mother was dead. I don't have brother, I don't have sister, I'm from Sudan. I give myself one useless name and they carry me, put the refugee camp. I was inside the boat, inside the sea, in a place called Malmo, in Sweden, southern part of Sweden. While I was inside that boat, I was there for 6 good months. No paper, no residence permit. What did I do? I escaped from the boat, I ran up to Stockholm. What next do I have to do? To go and chase woman to marry to get papers. Do you see the wicked level, the step I'm going? Step by step, entering into a wicked path. I went to marry a woman 12 years older than me. 12 years. Because I was looking for papers. How to survive. After picking up that 12 years old woman, she followed me to Nigeria, got married here, get papers, went back. After 3 years, I got my Swedish passport. Today, I'm a European citizen, but that made me think I was somebody. Forgotten that red passport does not give you access to better things in life. It can only give you access to errors and also demonic lifestyle. And I carry that passport, I enter into drug business. That's how I begin to kill people. I don't know what you have done that brought you here. Can I just say one thing to you? The thing I want to say to you right now is that you are not a criminal. Can I tell you who you are? Do you want to know who you are? You are a victim of circumstances. Do you want to know who is criminal? Come, let's go to the government house and show you criminals. You are not a criminal. Wait. I don't need you to come for me. No, I don't need your company. Listen to me. Hold on, there's no time. I have a very short time to spend with you. I just want to keep it real here so you know. And come here. Don't come here to ask you for tithes or offering. I don't come here to beg you. But I want you to change your way of living. If you think that crime can pay you, my brother, think again. Crime does not pay anything. For the person who is standing here, I was a brutal criminal. I made all kind of money. But today, where are the money? The money has not taken me anywhere. Are you hearing me, sir? It has not taken me anywhere. Don't think that you are a big boy. Don't think that crime is something that makes you so tough. No, you are not tough. You are just messing your life up. You are wasting your destiny. If you think that skin makes you a strong boy, no. Strong people are outside doing exploits. They are not inside the prison. I need a change. That's why I came. I came here to give you an example of myself. Because I had only primary 6 education. I've never been to secondary school. I've never been to university. But my father trusted me today to go around the whole world and preach the gospel. Tell people the truth. Because the Bible said only truth can set you free. And if you believe in the word I'm telling you here today, your freedom will come. Who do you think that can set you free? It's only Jesus Christ. When I entered into that den, I had a very big issue. Do you know what? I was carrying cocaine. I was a big drug dealer. I come to Nigeria, I carry Nigerian ladies, Nigerian girls, and I take them to place to go and swallow cocaine. One kilo cocaine inside their belly. Because I love money. When they finish swallowing to talk on across opera soup, they come to the airport. DCP, listen to this. When they swallow the 1 kilo cocaine, they get to the airport, the flight is cancelled. The next available flight is in 48 hours. That's 2 days. And you have 1 kilo cocaine in your stomach. Tell me how you're going to survive. Please be honest, how are you going to survive? 1 kilo cocaine is inside your body and your flight is cancelled, so you have no choice than to die with the cocaine in your stomach. Or you go and shit it out. You come to London, I will kill you because I will not trust you. I believe you sold my cocaine. So what do you think? Just think about it. They are afraid of me because if they come without the cocaine, I will kill them. So they better die with the cocaine than to come without the cocaine. That's how wicked I was. I'm not supposed to stand in your presence and talk to you. I am worse than anybody here. None of you have done what I did. I have killed thousands of people. And I'm going to tell you how I killed them. I am not here to make stories. I'm going to tell you the truth so that when you walk out from this place, you go to your cell room, you decide for yourself who you want to be. You want to be a Barawo? Go ahead. You want to be that Nisya down group or whatever you call yourself? Go ahead. You want to be a criminal? Go ahead. Anything you call yourself, just go ahead. But for me, I have chosen to follow Jesus Christ. I'm not going back. Nothing can stop it. It's my choice. Do you know what happened? Listen to me. Listen to me, please, sir. Because if we continue to clap in, we waste more time and time. I have no time to. I'm not seeking for people to praise me. I am here to only tell you the truth. Even if I die in the place of telling you the truth, so be it. I have been to the toughest place you can be in this world. I have entered into the dungeon that no one had ever entered. And I have stand like this, bullets pass through me and kill somebody behind me. God was preserving me for a purpose because he wanted me to go and tell the people the truth of what I've done. So many people came out from prison. They hide the truth. They don't want to say it because they think that they are a better person than any other person. I am not better than you. I am not better than you. In fact, even it's just I'm carrying this microphone, I'm also a sinner, if you don't know. I don't need to believe me, I'm also a sinner. Nobody is righteous here. The Bible says that we have all sinned and fallen short of glory of God. Everybody here is a sinner. But the truth of the matter is that when you hold on to the grace of God, that grace will carry you, it will sustain you. When you sin, you go on your knees and say, Father, show me mercy. Acknowledge that you are a wicked man. He will come and show you mercy. That is what transformed me, because I believe in the mercy of God. That's why I'm here today. My brother, many women died because of love of money. So many pretty girls died because of me. And sometimes you can come inside, you take 1 kilo cocaine and go to the high streets in London, sir. When you give them 1 kilo cocaine in London to sell, before they finish disposing that 1 kilo cocaine, minimum 10 or 20 people died. That is who killed them. Please be honest, I'm the one. No, who killed them? I'm the one. Because I'm the one that imported the cocaine. So I am the one. I'm the guilty one. Who made me better than you? I am not. We have made mistakes. Today is a day of transformation. The day that you woke up from your errors and say, I will never go back to crime. This is today, not tomorrow. It doesn't matter what you believe in. If you cannot take that decision today, forget about it. Because you will never see me here in this way again. We have 243 prisons in Nigeria. I have been to 165. This is 166 visits. So we still have many more prisons to go. I won't be coming here every day. Those that know me, in 4 years I've been in Nigeria, I've been to Kuche only 2 times. Today is my 3rd time. So before you see me here again, many of you have gone home. Many have gone home. And let me say this. The Bible says signs and wonders shall follow them that believe. If you only believe, your freedom will come. And if you don't want to believe, it's entirely up to you. Nobody will force you. I'm not forcing you. Man, listen to me, my big brothers, please. I love you all so much, and I'm going to tell you this testimony. If I don't share it, you'll be a travestor of justice. I don't want to walk out here without sharing it. Do you know that it doesn't stop like that? Sometimes 1 kilo cocaine could cost so many lives, 10, 20 lives. And young boys in London are walking around, selling it, shooting people, killing people in the street of Peckham, right, High Street, or London Heathrow Airport Day. From that place, we travel down to the east. From the east London, you see people are killing each other. But from the west, through the Heathrow side, nobody is killing anybody there. But that very place where black people are, we are causing nuisance, killing each other because of money. Because of money, just little nonsense that have no value. Because of that, we were dying. And at the end of it all, one day I heard the voice of the Lord say to me, my son, walk away from what you're doing or you'll be arrested. Do you know, sir, that I was one day driving and I sent my boy to send 1.5 kilo cocaine to somebody. As I was driving, I saw my boy standing in the bus stop.
As he was standing in that bus stop, I stopped and said, what are you waiting here for? He said that he missed the bus as they jump in. He put the 1.5 kilo cocaine in my boot. I have never in my life touched cocaine. Just pick it up like this, let me say, or touch even the bag of it or single one of it. I've never tried it before. Never. But that fateful day, I gave this boy 1.5 kilo cocaine to go and dispose to give somebody. And he stopped there waiting for bus and I picked him up. Not knowing that four police vehicles were monitoring me for the past 4 years. They were following me for 4 good years, sir. 4 years. I did not know. They followed me, they switched off the control lights, caused the traffic to stop, and they packed the whole car. That's how I stopped there. Christian Chuka, put your hand on the steering or we'll blow your brains out. That's how I surrender. They picked me up, the two hands became one. I found myself in prison. 9 months in police custody, no evidence that I was a criminal, except that they saw $3.2 million in account, offshore banking. That's only the evidence they have, that this man is a baron. But there is no other physical evidence, and that is not enough to put me in jail. That's not enough. They have to keep me there for 9 months and investigate, until finally they forged documents and nailed me, said that I will serve 15 years. But you know what? After 8 years, the mercy of God came because I gave my life to Christ. Do you know how it happened? I was one day sitting in my cell room, lying down and sleeping, watching pornographic movie. That pornographic movie I'm watching was Animal One. Some of Nigerian girls were doing animal pornographic movie in Italy, and the videos are very expensive. I will buy one, and you see animal horses, everything sleeping with Nigerian girls. This very particular one, this animal horses were forcing us to sleep with the girl. Finally, the girl fainted. My hand hit the remote control. The TV channel changed, and I saw a God channel there. Faithful Dollar Jimmy said, renew your mind or you will die. Change your mind and you will die. It was like pointing at my face. That's how fear gripped me. A bad boy like me, I've never been afraid of death. I've never been afraid of anything. That day, Holy Spirit came upon me. I began to shake. I was so afraid. That is how I surrendered my life to Christ. Since that day till today, I have never been to anything called crime. I've never tied or sold cocaine. I've never committed any sexual immorality. I kept myself off from everything that is wickedness. I dodge away from it because wages of sin is death. If you continue to do wicked things, it will come back at you. Whatever you sow, listen to me. If you make a ball now, bam, bounce ball on the wall, what will happen?
It come back.
I can't hear you. If you bounce ball at wall, it will bounce back at you. Whatever that goes around, what happens?
It comes around.
It comes around. If you think that you're a sharp guy that knows how to dagger people, kill people with knife, wait, for the knife is going to catch up with you. It's just like that. If you are good in trigger, pulling trigger, wait for trigger is coming to hit you one day. Trust me, you better have a change of heart. Life inside here in the prison, entered with primary 6 education, I used my time wisely. I began to study computer. Everything concerning computer. Today, I can do them with closing of my eyes. I learn good things. I never go inside prison to practice homosexuality. Sitting down and a man be sleeping with you from behind, that is madness. That is nonsense. Serious nonsense. You cussing. I have paid so much money in prison, in the going prison. People that have HIV because of that nonsense, madness, so-called homosexualism. I've been spending so much money to help the prisoners. I need cultural operations and everything. I've spent enough. I don't want to spend more. All I want you to do is a change of heart. Just change your heart. Come out from every wicked thing that you have been doing. And then come to Jesus Christ and you will see your feelings. You will see your freedom. That's what I needed to do. My brothers, you know that everything didn't end there. I came out from prison. We are 8 of us that are barons that are causing trouble in Europe and in America. 8 of us. Among all the 8, I came out from prison. I pick up my phone. Sir, because I was taking all my money, I thought I'm going to call my friends that will help me with money so I can start business again. I called all my 7 best friends. They were all dead. That is the testimony, sir. 7 of my best friends were all dead. The only person alive is me. And I was asking God, why me? I was bad and worse than those brother. My brother, listen, there is no other way. You have no other way. Surrender it all today. Give up everything today. And come to Jesus Christ and receive your freedom. I have other prisons, and everywhere I go to, when I share my testimony, I ask so many of them, what is your problem? He said, my problem is someone who will pay my 5,000 fine, I will go home. Some say 10,000 fine, I say, no. Jesus does not pay fine. All I will do is only to speak the word. When I speak, you got your freedom. What do you want? How many of you want your freedom? Let me see your hand up. You want your freedom? You want your freedom? Put the hand down. Put the hand down. No. I need to beg this so that you understand exactly what you're getting into. Because I'm going to pray. I am going to pray. This is not time for jokes anymore. When I say walking away from crime, I mean that you will turn your back completely from crime. You don't go and kill people anymore. You don't slaughter for because of money. You don't commit on robbing, kidnapping, all kind of nonsense called madness. You don't do those things anymore. And you say that everything concerning my life changed. I am standing here telling you the truth. If I'm lying, may God strike me to death. I have no reason to come and make up stories here. Listen to me. I am a changed man. I have changed. I'm no longer a bad guy. How many of you want to surrender their life to Christ? Lift up your hand, let me see your hands. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. Because I'm going to pray. Because this is the way to go out. Just make up your mind. Make up your mind. Just make up your mind. Don't be ashamed. Let me see your hand up. Let's pray. Surrender. Those that surrender all to Jesus Christ, let's pray because I have to go now. Keep your hands up. Don't be ashamed. If you're looking at your friend to support you, you are wasting your time. I might come here because of only this man. It might be because of him alone. I'm telling you, maybe I did not come for you. But it might be because of him and because of anybody. There is one person I have suffered for 4 days after this EP was there. For 4 good days I've been trying to come here and do program, and I couldn't come in. One thing I'm going to hinder me. But finally today, we got time to do it. The next time I'm going to see you, I want to see you outside, not here. Outside, not here. If you're willing to surrender all and make a change, don't you to turn away from evil ways. Let me see your hand, let's pray. Showed me Mr. Messi has come to you as well. Each and every one, your freedom has come.
Amen.
I mean, if you genuinely, I'm not talking about pretend. You can deceive me, you can deceive anybody here, but you cannot deceive God. If you have genuinely repented and found Jesus today, there is nothing that can hold you bound again. I want to see your hands again boldly. If you are offended, let me see your hand again up. Don't be ashamed. If you are ashamed of it today, you will be ashamed of it on the last day. Unto the Lord be the glory. Please listen to me, sir. It won't be spoiled in a second. because my time is up. It's exactly 5 o'clock now. Yeah. Okay, it's time is 5 o'clock now. I'm totally limited today, and that's why I have to rush. I have a longer and greater testimony to share with you. But listen to me. I'm waiting for you outside there.
Amen.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
Amen.
See, I have so many things to tell you. God bless you. God bless you all. I'm waiting for you outside there. There are so many things that we have to share with each other. There are so many truths to share with each other. But there's no time. Please. Discipline. I have it as a course on everywhere I go. When I finish, I give them my numbers. They come out, they call me. We see how to help them with their house, how to help them with what they are doing. Pick up your pen now. Take my number. Once you step out from this place, you call me. If you want person or two person, get a number, then you share with your friends, okay? 0809-302-8558. I say it again. 0809-302-8558. I say it again. The last time. Are you ready? 0809-302-8558. What will you do when you get your freedom? Sometimes you don't have a place to live, you don't have a place to stay. We try our best to find cheap houses, rent a room, and two people can share the room together. That's what we are doing to sustain the group until government will help us to build a rehabilitation home where you all can stay, okay? We have to keep on supporting you. May God bless every one of you. And yeah. God has given a lot of us now. I pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, I consecrate the bones of this one, sir. I consecrate their body, their soul, and spirit. No weapon against them shall prosper. They shall walk out in this place. They shall walk out of this place without any damage. Nobody will die here in the name of Jesus. No weapon come against you shall ever prosper. You will not be a victim in this place. But you shall be victorious. You shall be victorious. You shall be victorious. In the name of Jesus. God bless you all. See you outside. And listen to me one more thing here. 840 bottles of this. 840. And you are 808 here as of Monday. I don't know how many. I think today you are 804 people here. Everybody have one, and then everybody have one girl. It's a really wonderful place. Yes, one each. That's the little we can afford. Yes. The provost will come and pick the one for the cell. If you have 50 in a cell, they will pick 50 for the cell. Everybody, so please, we can be able to share. Everybody will get one. Whether you are delivered, whether you will get one. I love you all. Okay, God bless you. I love you all. I bless you all. To a good shit down. No
matter what. Wait, I stop. I know I said
everyone stop. Oh, please, please,
your life. Your life shall not be able to sacrifice. Your life shall not be able to sacrifice.